Hi, I am Prajnaparamita at Learning is Fun. Today, I am going to tell you an interesting story. A very nice story of a prince, the happy prince. The story was written by Oscar Wilde, the famous Irish writer. In this story, there is a prince who lived in his huge castle. He used to live a life of pleasure, happiness. He had everything when he was alive. But when he died, people built a huge statue of him. And the statue stands just at the center of the city. The statue was built in gold. And there were very precious jewels and jewelries and stones are there. What is that? The dress of that happy prince was made of gold, fine gold leaves. And there were two big sapphire, which was very rich, blue in color. They were in his eyes. And there was a huge ruby at his shoulder. Whenever people were passing by there, they used to appraise and they used to say to Happy Prince that this is the happiest person in the world. And by saying, at least they are only happy man in the town. And even the mother who tried to console her child by saying, Happy Prince never cries for new things. Why are you doing so? On a winter night, a group of swallow were passing over the city. They were going to Egypt for warmth. Suddenly, one of them left behind from his friend. And as he was left behind, he thought to take some rest in that unknown town. He said, all my friends left for warm Egypt. I will rest in this town for this night. By saying that, he tried to sleep a while. But when he was about to sleep at the foot of that statue, suddenly water drops came to him. And he was surprised because there was not a patch of cloud in the sky. The sky is clear, it's not raining. So out of curiosity, he flew up to see what was going on. And to his utter surprise, he found that the happy prince, the statue, was weeping. And he asked the statue, who are you? Why are you weeping? Then the statue explained the cause of his grief. That is, he is very sad when he saw the poor people in his country. And as now he is tired and he can't do anything for them, he requested Swallow to help him by saying, please help me, little Swallow. And at that time, he told Swallow that in a far corner of the city, he saw a poor young mother, tired. She was very tired and her only child was very ill and she had no money in her hand to buy even medicine or food for her child. At that sight, the little happy prince felt very unhappy and very sad and wished to help that lady. So what he did? He requested Swallow. Swallow, take the ruby from my sword hilt and give it to her. The swallow, after listening to it, feel pity to the prince. He said, I feel sorry at looking you. I will help you. So he took the ruby from his sword and flew to that young mother and gave it to her. When he returned, suddenly Swallow felt a strange feeling within, because it was cold outside, but still he was feeling warm. So what was it? He asked Happy Prince, it is cold night, but strange, I am feeling warm. Then Prince replied, that happens when you do something good to help someone. The next day, the swallow decided to fly for Egypt. So he came to the prince to bid him farewell or say goodbye. I will leave for Egypt tonight. I will stay with you through the day. At that time, the happy prince became very sad because he don't wish to lose his friend. And he said, please stay with me for one more night. And he told Swallow that now he saw a poor dramatist at his home. He was very hungry and he don't have money even to buy food and finish his writing. The prince requested him again and again. The swallow took the sapphire and flew to that poor dramatist. Again the next day, the swallow came to the prince. And now he was determined he will fly for Egypt. Now he said, I am going to Egypt. I am here to say goodbye. The prince was sad again and again requested Swallow to help him for another time. And he said he saw a poor little girl in the town square and said Swallow to take the sapphire from his other eye and give it to the girl. Now Swallow protested, no, no, impossible, I can't do it, I can't make you blind. But the prince requested him so badly again and again, say, please Swallow, please do this for me. And the swallow took the other sapphire and flew to that little girl. And the next night the swallow again came to prince. And at that time, Swallow didn't willing to go to Egypt. Why, you know? Because the swallow said, you are blind now, so I must stay with you always. And at the time, the prince told Swallow that if you are staying with me, please fly over the land and see what you see there. And the swallow go to the city to see what were there. When the swallow returned to the prince, it described everything saw there. That is the poor people, the miseries, the sufferings of the people. And at that time, the prince again feel pity and requested Swallow to take all the gold from his body and give it to the poor people. Now the swallow did. At night, the swallow again came to the prince. Now swallow finally bid him farewell, because swallow was now dying. And he said, goodbye, my prince. And the prince thought, oh, you are going to Egypt. But swallow replied, no, the cold has got me. I am dying. Saying that, he fell into the feet of the prince and died. The next day, people of the city came there and they saw the very ugly statue of Happy Prince. There was no gold, no ruby, no sapphire. So the mayor and the councillor, they came and they declared that no need to keep the statue anymore because it is not so much beautiful. And they decided to take it to the furnace and melt it. And they will build another statue. With that idea, whose statue it would be, they begin to fight against one another. And the night falls. One angel from the sky came there and took the swallow and the prince to the garden of God. God told them that you did a good work and noble work in the world. You help people, you sacrifice everything, even your life. So you can stay with me now forever. And if you listen to the story, if you understand this, you can answer this question. Try yourself and think yourself. Does happiness lies in wealth? And who is a true friend, do you think? If you have any problem, if you have any problem in understanding the story, please do comment in my comment box. I will definitely answer them very quickly. And I will soon, very shortly, I will come with my new slide and more thing about Happy Prince. No more today. Bye-bye.